Ortiz. That would be nice.
Berto with 8 first round knockouts. Zavit with 1. That happened in his pro debut. When we asked about the speed difference to Zavit, he said, I'm a lot faster than you think. We're going to find out.
Here comes Addis with the opening bell.
Oh, right there. He hit Berto with a good overhand right there. Right there. Berto got to be careful, though.
We're in Biloxi, Mississippi, HBO Boxing After Dark. Jan Zavit defending his welterweight belt against Andre Berto. Berto coming off the loss to Victor Ortiz back in April.
Well, looks like we're going to get an action pack right here. I don't see nobody really ready to take one back with steps.
Looks as though Berto's determined to show everyone that he hasn't been adversely affected by the knockout, Roy, but he's not gun shy. Excuse me, by the loss, not a knockout. He's dropped, but not knocked out. The body shots from Berto.
Great body shots by Berto. A good body shot by Zavit, too, though.
Zavit defended his title back in February, his last fight against Paul Delgado. Stopped him in the fifth round.
Hand-picked opponents for Berto. That's not Berto doing the hand-picking. He's a willing fighter. That's drunk throughout his career. I think questioning his ability to take a punch and win at the very highest level. But Berto is lightning fast. He really gives you something to watch there. He's aggressive, and he has a ton of heart.
And he's already taken some really good punches in this fight already. And he's landed some pretty good punches in this fight already. Especially to the body.
Good right hand by Berto, getting Zavit going back.
One of the things that maybe has hindered Berto's development as a fighter a little, Roy, has been that he is so offensive, that he is so squared up to his opponent looking to punch.
Well, it's funny because we saw the same thing in the guy in the Kobe tonight with Jared Russell. They fight very similar, they just have 2 different weight classes. Berto's a guy who also stays in the pocket, who can defend and also can unchain. So this is what we love to see in boxing because it makes for great fights.
I think everything except for the defense part.